video, you will learn to look at the structure of molecules and rank their boiling points from lowest to highest. Let's first think about what boiling is by looking at the example of water. Simply said, boiling is the transition from the liquid phase to the gas phase. And we can look at the molecules in each of these phases. In the gas phase, molecules are much more separated and spread out, as you can see here. However, in the liquid phase, intermolecular interactions, in this case hydrogen bonds, hold the molecules together. So, in order for boiling to occur, and molecules to enter this gas phase, there must be enough energy present to break these intermolecular interactions that hold the molecules together. This brings us to the key boiling point concept. The stronger the intermolecular interactions, the more energy is needed to break them, and thus, the higher the boiling point. So, when assessing trends in boiling points of different molecules, you must first look at the strength of the possible intermolecular interactions. Remember that the strongest interaction is an ion-ion interaction, as it involves full charges. The next strongest category of interactions is ion-dipole interactions. Then comes hydrogen bonds and dipole-dipole interactions. Note that hydrogen bonds are a specific example of dipole-dipole interactions. At the weaker end of the spectrum, we have dipole-induced-dipole, and finally, van der Waals, or induced-dipole-induced-dipole interactions. To determine the strongest type of intermolecular interaction possible, you'll need to look at the functional groups present in each molecule. So let's consider these two molecules, propanol and butane. Remember that we consider the molecules in a sample of only themselves, so it might be helpful to draw a second molecule of each. The butane can form van der Waals interactions, while the propanol can form hydrogen bonds, as it has both acceptor and donor groups. Van der Waals interactions are a lot weaker than hydrogen bonds, so the boiling point of propanol is higher than the boiling point of butane. But wait a minute, what if there's a situation when the type of molecules that can be formed are the same for multiple molecules? Let's take a look at a group of molecules that can all form van der Waals interactions. For van der Waals interactions, the strength of this interaction between molecules increases with the surface area. Or in other words, longer chains with a higher number of carbons will have a higher boiling point. Similarly, when comparing molecules with the same number of carbons, branching will reduce the interaction surface area and thus result in a lower boiling point. In a second example, let's compare propanol versus propylamine. In this example, both molecules can form hydrogen bonds, as they both have hydrogen bond donor and acceptor groups. But we need to consider that these hydrogen bonds can differ in strength. The strength of hydrogen bonds depends on the electronegativity of the atoms involved. Nitrogen has a lower electronegativity than oxygen, which results in less strong hydrogen bonds. Propylamine will thus have a lower boiling point compared to propanol. In a last example, we can compare propanol and propionic acid, which again can both form hydrogen bonds. The functional groups of these molecules all have oxygen atoms in them, so there's no use in looking at the electronegativity differences. The difference in boiling point here is due to the total number of acceptors and donors that each molecule has. Propionic acid has the carbonyl group, in addition to the hydroxyl group, and thus has extra hydrogen bond acceptor groups compared to propanol. As a result, propionic acid can form more hydrogen bonds per molecule and has a higher boiling point. Now you know the key points to understand trends in boiling points. These same principles can be used to help you understand trends in other transitions, such as melting points.